to think that that TIFF, that person, was what was required if I was using the terminal. When I first started learning how to code, I thought, I want to get to that level where I have tons and tons of terminals open and I'm just this hardcore coder, only to grow in my coding career, become a senior developer, and realize I want the opposite of that. I want something that is user-friendly, helps me work faster and quicker, not this ridiculous, complex, and very unnecessary setup. Today, I'm going to be taking you with me to really explore Warp. Warp, as they say on their website, and honestly, after you play around with it, I'm sure you will agree, is the terminal for the 21st century. It is so user-friendly, really helps with various workflows, and okay, I'm gonna dive into it in a second, but first, let's go get some coffee. Okay, we got all the drinks. Please tell me that I am not the only one who cannot work or start working unless I have all of the drinks, but most importantly, obviously, coffee. Today, we are going to be diving into Warp, and I'm sure you've seen Warp on social media or from other people or maybe heard about it, and there's a good reason for it. When I started playing around with Warp, which is quite a while ago actually, because I was like many of you, I kept on seeing it come up, and organically online, people were talking about it. I'm like, why is this terminal so special? Or what makes it everyone so excited about it? So I wanna share with you today about Warp and how it can really improve your process using a terminal. Also too, when you're starting out or even when you're senior, I mean, I'll speak for myself anyways, using the terminal, there's always things about it that come up that really are annoying or I get lazy. And in turn, I just don't take the time to really learn properly, or I spend my entire career Googling. Warp solves a lot of that. It has a very friendly CLI. And you know, I'm on their website right now. They describe themselves as the terminal for the 21st century. And I think that is so true, because when you really think a lot about some of the terminals we use and how we use them, it's the same in many ways that we've used them for way too long. Like, it's not evolving or advancing. So Warp really took it to the next level, and I'm really excited to dive into it with you today. Two of the things that we'll dive into in a bit here, but that really stood out to me about Warp is their input editor and also two blocks. So with their input editor, it's essentially a full text editor that supports selections, cursor positioning, shortcuts that you're used to using in other apps. So the UI, user experience, not UI, but yeah, no, user experience. It's very friendly and something that you're familiar with doing in other apps already. Also too, I'm a huge visual person or a visual learner, visual worker, and I really enjoy how they have blocks in their terminal. So what that means is commands and output are visually grouped together into blocks. So you can select which block you would like and see all your different commands that you've been using in block section. So it's very visual. Now, both of these we'll dive into more, but I just wanted to highlight them as well, that these are two areas that really made Warp stand out for me. All right, let's dive into modern text editing. At first I was like, this isn't that big of a deal, modern text editing, what really is it? Until you start playing around with it and you realize how many pain points that this really resolves. So let me pull up their documentation to start with. Unlike other terminals, Warp's input editor operates out of the box like a modern IDE and the text editors we're used to. Okay, interesting. Warp supports soft wrapping in the input editor. If there's auto suggestions that go off screen, the input editor will be horizontally scrollable to make it more visible. That's also really interesting. All right, so you can see here, they also share how to use it, different shortcuts to use for it, and the description. Let's start playing around with it. All right, on screen now, I have opened the Warp terminal. And one thing I really like about it is if you see here in the top right-hand corner, when you open this up, it will give you Warp Essentials. Also too, if you click on this little keyboard here, you will have access to keyboard shortcuts. So the UI is really user-friendly. It allows you to get started really quickly, which I love, because something I think I'm gonna say as most developers, oftentimes we just want something to work, which is kind of counterintuitive as to what our jobs are a lot of the time. Things don't work a lot of the time. But when you're introducing a new tool into your workflow, the last thing you want is it for it to be difficult to use. You want it to just work. You have enough problems on the go. So I like how they have these Warp Essentials, and then also too, they have Warp AI, which is right here, which we will dive into in a sec. But to get back to the modern text editor, one thing I think is really cool is, let's write a sentence here, just say, today in Toronto is very warm. I love the sunshine. Okay. Now, one of the first things you will notice is typically you are not able to click anywhere you want in a terminal. In this case, though, you can. So for example, say I made a spelling mistake or I wanted to change a word, which is so common when you're writing commands. You can simply click wherever you would like and make this change. Very cold. That's pretty accurate. It's very cold in Toronto. Another thing with this text editor is you can write multi-lines. So if you simply enter, say you want to enter twice, tomorrow is going to be a bit warmer in the city. So this is really interesting as well. You can keep on writing multi-lines. So when you are, say, looking inside a folder, then going inside of it, it's very easy to do all at once in a very user-friendly way. Like, it looks very nice, which I think nowadays, because we are using so many different applications that are user-friendly, our terminal needs to reflect that as well. Another thing you can do is select the entire editor. So say you want to completely start again. We do no longer need to. Oftentimes I'll just quit the terminal because I don't want to keep on hitting the backspace. So this is really handy as well. You can also copy and paste. So say copy, start a new line, and paste this. Very user friendly, very simple to get started with. Next up, I want to talk about blocks. So you can see on screen here, I am back in their documentation. I always go back to the documentation because as a reminder to myself, that's the best place to start always. And right now we are under block basics. It shows you how to create a block, select a single block, a lot we'll get into, select multiple blocks. But essentially, as you can see here, just even in this clip, you can see how these are blocked, these blocks are blocked, but how the different commands are within their own blocks. And this is super helpful if you want to ensure, if you want to bookmark one of these blocks, which we'll show in a second here as well, or if you want to share one of these blocks. There's so many user-friendly activities that you can do within that. And then on the side here, you can see that there are block actions, sharing, and sticky command or header. All right, let's get into it. Okay, first of all, let's go into a project. Okay, now I'm back in Warp, and let's go get into a project. So CD, desktop, let's go on our desktop. And then let's see, let's do project 1.1. I'm terrible at naming my projects. It's just a fact of life. Let's look inside here, index, da, da, da. Okay, perfect. I don't even know what project this is because of the bad naming. It's terrible. I'm one of those offenders who too often has a crazy messy desktop, and then when I get tired of looking at it, I just put everything in documents or sometimes in the trash. I know, I'm terrible. But you can see here already, even just speaking to you, that we are creating some blocks. So we have the first one up here, going into our project, then looking inside of our project, and now in our project, we haven't created this block yet, but the new blocks are always created at the bottom. All right, this is Tiff coming from the future. I wanted to share that you can actually toggle your settings so your blocks start at the top and cascade down. Here's a tweet with a video that Warp posted a few weeks ago going through this. A really interesting thing as well is if you hover over one of these, you can see here, you can bookmark this block to quickly scroll to it. So if there is a command that you are writing often or something that maybe, I know for myself anyways, when I was working at IBM, and a lot of times we're working on these massive projects, right? And I was on the consulting side for clients. It was around cherry picking I had to do a few times, and I struggled with it so much that I would leave the command, I typed it into myself into Slack, bookmarked it in Slack, and then I would copy and paste it every time. And now with something like this in with Warp, you don't actually have to make these workarounds. They're right here in your terminal. So let's have an interesting command to do for this. So say you wanted to say git status, let's say git status. Not a git repository. This has not become a git repository yet. So say you wanted to make this a git repository. Git init, and now we are on the head. So say we wanted to save, I don't know, let's say we want to save this command. So all you need to do is hover here, bookmark, and then if we keep on going, all right, so you can see here I did some more commands since the git commit, or git init, sorry, which is bookmark. I did git status and then git add, because as I mentioned, this was just a little project I did, I don't even remember exactly which one. I didn't realize that I was adding all the node modules, which actually worked out well though, because then what happened was git add, git status, and I added all of these node modules, removed all the node modules, but in turn, because this is something that maybe isn't as common, maybe it's not a specific example as common, hopefully that often, but at the end of the day, the point being is you can see here, now after making a lot of different commands and using the terminal a lot, if there is a command that I have bookmarked, you can see here, it will be bookmarked, little blue, you can hover over it and it will show what the command is. If you click on it, it will take you right to that, which is really handy, especially for people who are always on their terminal using it. Also too, something that would have come in handy all the time for me when working on Teams is you can actually share these blocks. So as you can see here, if you toggle to the three dots, I think it's called the hamburger. No, hamburger is when it's longer lines. What is the shorter one called? It's just three dots, not the three lines. Is it a hamburger still? Leave in the comments, I'm curious now. You can see here though, that you can create a permalink and share a block with people. Create a link to your block and share it with your coworkers or community. This is super handy if you are working with more junior developers, senior developers, and you want to share a specific command or a block that you have executed for them. Super helpful. All right, one more time, I'm coming to you from the future, or I guess when you watch this, it'll be the past. But I also wanted to highlight that you can create a permalink of this block and share it with your team members or whomever. Essentially, a shared block is a web page with the output that has full support for syntax highlighting and link clicking. The amount of time this would have saved me, and honestly still saves me, working on different projects, especially for projects that we're working on together on this channel or building, being able to link them down below would be really interesting. Now I'm thinking of future project ideas. What else should we be building? All right, anyways, you get the point. You can share these blocks, they're super cool. Okay, let's talk about the feature I'm most excited about. Why? Because I'm getting sucked into all the hype, but it's actually really, really handy, which is Warp AI. So as I mentioned earlier in this video, that there is this toggle up here and you can click on it, Warp AI. Why I get so excited about this is because the amount of time it will reduce for me to Google or go on Stack Overflow and just have this right inside my terminal, it's a game changer. And so as you can see, when I open it up, it suggests some things that are common, such as how do I undo the most recent commits in Git? How do I find all the files containing specific text? Write a script to connect to AWS. Like, it is so handy. So let's do something fun. You know I like to automate things with Python a lot of times, so let's do something. Write a Python script to find all PNG files in my documents folder. The suspense. All right, so as you can see here, here's a Python script that uses the OS and FN match modules to find PNG files in the doc folders. So you can see here, import, the path, the script, So that's pretty cool. So now let's say, what should I do next? Or you can do show examples, how do I fix this? Depends on what you want to achieve. If you have a specific task in mind, Okay, so say, how do I run the above command? All right, navigate to the directory. You save the Python script, the script in using cd command. For example, if you saved it in the docs folder, run the script using Python followed by the name of the script file. All right, let's try this. All right, so let's run this. I just saved this file, main.py, in my documents folder. So let's go back into documents, let's go CD. I guess I could have just gone straight into it, but that's okay. Okay, so now if I look inside, you should be able to see. This is probably really embarrassing because there's so much stuff in here, but it's main.py, here we go. So now what we can do is, as it mentions, run the script using Python, followed by the name of the script. So Python main.py. This is super cool. So it's really messy, but you can even see when I first, this is really cool and scary how many PNGs I have. Don't judge me. Or you can judge me a little bit. I would judge myself a little. I do judge myself a little. But the point being, you can see here that at first I just did Python main.py. I was just kind of going quickly. Didn't work, but rather than just being completely, you know, stumped at that point, it gives a suggestion. Python 3, type it in, and there you go. This is a game changer. I'm super pumped about this. All right, next, let's customize our terminal, and you can get very specific with your customizations with Warp. For this, I'm just going to share with you what comes out of the box, but honestly, it takes about 3 minutes to even create your own theme or use one of their themes. The documentation, as I keep on saying, is really good. There's also some videos embedded in the documentation that you can follow along. But for this, just to get a sense of it, you can see already I changed the color of my terminal. And to do that, you can simply navigate to settings here, go to appearance, current theme, and then it will click on that and then you can see a bunch of different ones. Dark, light, I know, it's burning everyone's eyes with the light. Dracula, solar eyes, that's what I'm on. I kind of like this one too. It's kind of vintage feeling. Jellyfish is really cute too. So there's so much that comes right out. Ooh, I like leafy. We're doing leafy. We're committing to the leaf. It's so nice. It makes me feel like I'm in a tropical place, even though I'm in the middle of downtown Toronto. So you can see themes can get really out of the box, very interesting already. And then you can once again go into customizing your own theme. All right, the last thing I want to touch on or leave with you, leave this, pass on my wisdom. No, there's no wisdom. But the last thing I want to share with you is really how you can access a lot of these commands very quickly. So as I mentioned throughout this video, one of the key things when you are using a new tool is you want it to just work. You already have enough on your plate. And to access a lot of these commands within Warp, all you need to do is do Command P, and it will open up this panel here where you can search for a command or type to specifically go to one. So it's from AI to clear selected lines, copy, all of the commands are right here. So this is a great way too when you're getting started with Warp. If you forget a command or how to do something within Warp, you can easily do Command P and it will pull it all up.